Tesla first unveiled the solar glass roof back in 2018, and I was really excited. Actually, of all Tesla's products, maybe the most excited about that one. You guys know I love solar. But fast forward 5 years, and it hasn't really made much of a splash commercially. The adoption's been really low. So I wanted to come out here to this beautiful house to figure out what we can do about that. Because I think it turns out it's not really the product so much as how we're building houses. So let's figure this out together. I'm Ricky, and this is 2-Bit DaVinci. We're here in Moody, Texas at this custom, beautiful custom home. And we're gonna show you the power walls and the Tesla solar roof here in a second, but I wanted to show you this behind me. This lake is a reservoir for overflow when it rains heavily, which it does here, just unpredictably. This will be completely full. And if you look, the owner just told me it's only been this low maybe once before in the last 30 years that he's owned this property. But if you look here, there's a little dry dock. It has it built on rails, so it'll raise up. So eventually, when it does rain later this year, it is an El Nino year, this water level will be pretty much about 1 foot below where we're standing. So that is the nature of severity of how much water and rain and drought and just weather can happen. And so this is one of those reasons. It's about 100 degrees out here right now. And in the winter, it can get freezing. If you guys remember in 2021, when natural gas lines froze and people were without power for 5 or 6 days. So for the owner of this house, his top priority, not saving money on his bills, which he does want to do, but it's being energy independent and not being reliant on the grid. So now let's go figure out how his solar roof accomplishes that. So you guys know I'm retrofitting my old house to be modern and solar powered, but this being here at a new construction site makes me so jealous because there's nothing like intentionalness and deliberately making decisions in the interest of what you want to do. Here is a look at all the electronics going on here. Tesla gateways, they're already pre-wired for 4 Tesla power walls. And right above us is the Tesla solar roof. Ultimately, what it comes down to is you can never retrofit something that wasn't designed the way you wanted it in the first place. You can get close, you can try, but there's no replacement for designing it the right way. In this case, like we mentioned, this wall where the solar roof goes up is facing the right orientation, southward. It has the right angle for ideal solar collection. And also, it has a single plane, right? There's no A gable style roof to this, which means that entire roof can produce solar power. There's no bends, there's no wrong way to put the panels, and no decisions to make, like should we have these be producing panels or not? This entire roof can mostly produce solar. And behind me, we're looking at 17 kilowatts of solar generation. Pretty impressive. So I'm here with Lou, the homeowner, and here we are on top of this beautiful Tesla glass roof. Tell me a little bit about the thought process that went into designing this.
Well, it was intentional. I know you used that word earlier about the fact that we were very intentional in terms of planning this very early on. It took us 2 years total in terms of designing the house. We met with the architect. I said, I want solar tiles and I don't want to take away from the rest of the aesthetics of the modern industrial design that we have. So this is where we landed.
And what's really brilliant about what you've done here is you have different roof lines. This roof is just its own thing. It's not part of the bigger house.
Correct.
So hopefully you can hear us over the wind. So the cool thing with that is you allowed yourself to go Tesla solar roof here and standing seam in other places. You didn't have to decide. My house is one giant blob of roof. I couldn't do that. I couldn't say, hey, let's make this half a Tesla solar glass roof and this traditional. I didn't have that option. But by breaking up the roof line and also having this one big slanted single pane of roof line, you've got entire solar coverage.
Correct. It's just like one big panel on this shed roof.
The way I didn't know you could walk on these. This is if they're hail proof, I'd imagine
exactly.
It has to be.
Yep. One of the things that led us to where we are is in the planning process, Ricky, is that, you know, us Texans, we kind of value our independence. And I really feel like that the power grid here in the state is pretty vulnerable. I think it's vulnerable nationwide, but especially in Texas. And we just wanted that ability to have independence from the power grid. So we designed the roof to fit the house. So within probably a couple of thousand kilowatt hours for the entire year, we're going to be able to produce enough energy from this panel to go and power the whole house since 4,200 square feet.
So you have 17 kilowatts of solar, you have four Tesla Powerwalls, which is over 50 kilowatt hours of storage.
Correct.
And you have a natural gas, or is it propane?
It's a propane generator, okay. Auxiliary power.
And you've got a tank offsite?
Got a 500 gallon tank on this side and a 500 gallon tank on the other side of the house.
So it would take like a zombie apocalypse, and maybe even not then, for you to have any kind of disruption to your power.
Yeah, we don't plan on that.
So we talk about solar a lot, but really it comes down to three pillars. One is environmentalism. Some people want to do that.
Right.
That works. Two is saving money on your bills, which I don't know if that was a huge driver for you, but for us in California, that's the big one.
It's it always helps to have a return on the investment.
Sure. And three is being prepared for emergencies. You mentioned you were in San Diego when Hurricane Hillary rolled through.
Right.
Turned out to be not a whole bunch of nothing, but I was scared.
Sure.
But I didn't have to worry about my house, at least, because we had solar and batteries, right?
Right.
It is an ultimate peace of mind.
Yeah. There were a lot of people in what we called the snowvid period, where we had massive blackouts. And you know, we were talking earlier about some people were out of electricity for 5 to 10 days, and we won't have to worry about that here.
By the way, I've still never been to a Tesla event, and now that the referral program is back and they allow you to buy tickets for future events, we would love it if you could use our referral link. If you're buying a Tesla car, solar Powerwall, or solar glass roof, check out the links in the description using our link. It would really help us to eventually go to one of these things. All right, back to the show.
So a huge thanks to Pablo and the Good Faith Energy team for inviting us out here to Texas to see this amazing job site. Thanks so much for having us, by the way.
Definitely, yeah. Thanks for coming out, man. Took a long journey to get here.
Yeah. So tell us about what you guys have learned. How about some numbers? How much solar does Good Faith Energy install versus Tesla glass roof?
Yeah, so on average, we're doing like 300 or so solar systems per year.
Okay.
Solar roofs, we've been doing for almost 4 years now. I think we just hit our 50th solar roof, so we've done quite a few of these. It's slowly ramping up. You know, Tesla's helping out with the marketing a little bit more now, which is great. You know, I think we're going to see a lot more of these in the near future.
That's good news. What could we learn as far as how to build houses better, or in what situations can this thrive and be more prolific?
Sure. So the complexity factor of your roof is very important when installing these. So when you're going to design a house, or if you have a house that's already built out and you're going to retrofit a system like this, having a roof that is simple and facing south is definitely going to be optimal. So if you are building a house from scratch, make sure that you have a roof that faces the south, the west, the east, and it's not complex, no penetrations. You want something that's nice and flat and facing the sun. We actually cover all of Texas, but okay. Solar and EV chargers, batteries, North Texas, we're all over the place.
So if you live in North Texas and you're looking for a Tesla Powerwall or solar roof install, definitely check out Good Faith Energy. We'll have links in the description. Thanks so much, by the way.
Hey, thanks a lot.
Let's go check out this house a little bit more.
Yeah, let's do it.
So first of all, I didn't realize you can walk on this just like any other roof, but you can. It kind of makes sense. The Good Faith Energy team just told me that this is a more resilient roof in the event of a hailstorm than a traditional roof. That, to me, that was crazy. Like, what could happen to an asphalt shingle roof? Apparently a lot. They just get beat right through and you got to replace them. And these, if one of these does crack, you just pop one panel off, attach a couple of wires and pop it back in. You can just replace individual tiles. And Tesla has a 25-year warranty. So let me just come out off the bat and say, I love this product as much as I ever did. I think it's absolutely gorgeous. This is the prettiest roof I've ever seen. And what's really amazing is the fact that it's one piece, it's not a part of the other house. He was able to just do the Tesla roof on this portion and do whatever else he wanted elsewhere. So in the future, we should build houses this way, large, single planes of roofing that faces the sun. And then you can have other parts of the house with detached roof lines. The minute every roof ridge and vent has to come together to one giant blob, it gets so complicated. And that's where this roof falls apart. The prices become astronomical. I got a quote for $125,000 for my house. By the time they came out and actually measured it, that doubled to over $200,000. Why? Because my roof was not made to produce energy. It wasn't designed, it wasn't intentionally made that way. Let's hope in the future that we can do a better job of that, because the end result is this seamless roof. Look at this, there's no ridges, no vents, there's no pipes. All the sewer drains and stuff are side mounted. And from the roof ridge to the very bottom, there is not one part that doesn't just look uniform and clean. An amazing product, and hopefully if we design houses more intentionally for solar, we can make this more and more cost effective. So following with a ultra modern new construction, look at the level of insulation. This is all spray foam insulation. And look at how thick this is. I am in the attic. This is not a conditioned space. This is not a place you're supposed to spend any amount of time. But I'm feet from the roof and I'm comfortable. It's a little bit warm, that's about it. That's what incredible levels of insulation can do. And as I'm looking through here, you can just see everything. Everything has been blown in. This is amazing, really. This is what I can't do in my house. This is what I'm fighting against. When I have to run air conditioning more often, it's because I don't have this. This is the power of starting from scratch and doing it from the ground up with intention. Let's get back in the main house. Now, a lot of people think the roof, the part that you see, is a part that keeps you high and dry. But actually, the real hero is underlayment. And this is what goes underneath the roof that you see there. Now, Tesla is notorious, or not notorious, it's famous for vertically integrating. And part of what they've done is now they make their own. This is a Tesla branded underlayment. Really, really thick. And this is what actually gives you your waterproofing. The roof on top, really its job is to protect the underlayment from getting beat down by the ultraviolet light and degrading prematurely. All right, and this is it. This is my first time actually being hands on it. The first thing you realize, you can kind of see how it's layered up, but this is a big shatterproof piece of glass. And the really cool thing, what makes it look so special, is that texture that they have. That can't be easy to do, but that's what really gives the illusion of being like a slate tile or something else. But the producing part would be underneath here, protective glass on top to keep the panels from degrading from UV light like any solar panel. But overall, it just looks like a roof tile. Here's kind of, I think this is where you screw them down to, right? And you got your channels that you can attach to each other. And like we mentioned, if you had one break, you would just be able to replace one individually. And this is a non-producing tile. The producing tiles look pretty much identical. You might be able to see it under certain angles possibly, but they would have MC4 solar connectors coming off of it. But this is what you would put and you'd blend it in, and depending on how much you want to produce or what part of the roof you're on, you would blend in non-producing and producing, but ultimately you couldn't tell. They look the same.
So let's tackle the elephant in the room, which is price. So like I mentioned, our price doubled from when we first got quoted to actually the final numbers, from about $120,000 to well over $200,000. And that's because of the complexity of our roof. Our roof is it's a really big and long house, kind of a ranch style. And it does have a pretty complex roof. It's been added on to over the years. So it's just kind of challenging. But this was brilliant. Let's talk a little bit about money. So for Lou's property, he paid about $150,000 total, right? Of that, that includes four Tesla Powerwalls. So that's about $50,000. So of that $150,000, about $100,000 is for the Tesla solar roof. Now that's actually pretty good because the rest of his house is standing seam metal, which is another premium product and pretty expensive. And you have to also remember he has 17 kilowatts of solar production. So to put that into perspective, we have 11 kilowatts. We paid about $30,000. Just for that much solar, like traditional panels, would cost well over $50,000. That means that Tesla solar roof was only really about $50,000, and that's not all that bad. A standing seam metal roof plus panels might have been around that price, all because it was one uniform plane of a roof.
So this is the Tesla solar glass roof. Honestly, it's as amazing as I thought it would be. I'm pretty blown away. The problem with it comes down to the homes that you're putting them on. Here, if you have a single slant roof, this is literally the easiest installation humanly possible. The Good Faith Energy team was out here in 2 half days and got this done. A typical solar roof can take a week to up to 2 weeks because every time you get to a corner or a ridge, you gotta slow down, make all the little cuts, all the caps, all the plates and everything else. But this does make sense. But I think what it illustrates is a bigger problem that we have. We are building houses the old ways that we always have. Instead of reimagining how we should probably look forward to building homes. Here in Texas, the population is booming. They've seen double-digit year-over-year growth in population and with no signs of slowing down. Tesla's here, Austin and Dallas, these areas are booming and the populations are gonna continue to grow. And as every new development comes online and builds a house, that is more and more demand on the grid. And as Lou mentioned, the grid's already kind of strained and in sometimes it could be problematic. So when we build a new house, we should build solar as part of the design. There's no better thing your roof can do than make the energy you need, not just for saving money, but for being prepared for emergencies. or everything else. So let's reimagine how we build houses. Let's build them with solar intentionally. Let's orient the roof lines in the right way, and let's build them to be maximum solar collectors. And here's perfect proof. This gorgeous house behind me, that you can have a gorgeous architectural marvel and still have it intentionally built for solar. So yes, the solar glass roof hasn't taken off, but we are starting to see more and more stock, and the popularity is still there. So for now, it'll be a premium product for people who have a lot more money than most of us will. But eventually, I think a product like this, maybe 5 years from now, could come down market and actually be as cost-effective as any old-fashioned roof. So let's hope for that day, because this thing is absolutely gorgeous. All right, so thank you so much for watching. Check out this video next. And until next week, I'm Rico Tuba Da Vinci. Thank you for watching.